Hello and welcome to this presentation. My name is Konstantinos Bougioukas and I am a postdoctoral researcher at Aristotle University of Thessaloniki in Greece. Firstly, I would like to thank ESMAR Conference for the chance to present our work. In this presentation, we are going to discuss about an R package called ccaR that provides easy-to-use functions for assessing the degree of overlap of primary studies in an overview of reviews. So, before I get started, I would like to introduce the other members of the team. Theodoros Diakonidis helped with coding on the package and designed the Signy app. Anna Mavromanoli and Anna-Bettina Haidich helped to publish a relative paper with use cases and examples. The evidence-based medicine pyramid, the pyramid on the left side of this slide, consists of primary studies, observational and experimental, which are the sources of information for clinical evidence. Both systematic reviews, which are the first level of evidence synthesis, and overview of reviews, which are the second level of evidence synthesis, can be considered as lenses through which evidence from primary studies is viewed. Therefore, the unit of synthesis for an overview of reviews is the review study. One of the key methodological challenges unique to overview of reviews is the management of overlapping data due to the inclusion of the same primary studies in the reviews. The researchers may need to explore the degree of overlap at the overview level and the outcome level. The corrected covered area, CCA index, has been used as a quantitative measure of the extent of primary study overlap across the included reviews. In order to calculate the CCA index, we need to create a matrix, which is usually called citation matrix. All functions included in the ccaR package use the CCA index. There are two versions of the formula, the original CCA index and the adjusted one. If the authors consider structural missingness when they create the citation matrix, the adjusted version is calculated automatically by the functions of the package. Structural missingness refers to the missing data of the matrix for a logical reason. For example, primary studies were published after the conduct of a specific systematic review. Therefore, it was not possible to be included in the review. This is a chronological structural missingness. As we can see, in the CCA formula, the N is the sum of ones in the citation matrix, R equals to the number of rows of the matrix corresponding to the unique primary studies in the reviews, C is the number of columns of the matrix corresponding to the number of reviews, and the X in the adjusted formula is the sum of the X's in the matrix which denote the structural missingness. Additionally, visual methods such as Venn and Euler diagrams, upset plots, heat maps, and node-link graphs can be used for depicting potential overlap in overview of reviews. For the rest of the presentation, I am going to focus on the ccaR package, which is available at github.com/thdiacon/ccaR, and it can be downloaded using the install_github function from the DevTools package. First, the functions of the ccaR package expect a data frame, which is the citation matrix, and may be a first view of the overlapping reviews. In this matrix, the first row should contain the names of the included reviews, and the first column should contain the names of the unique primary studies included in the reviews. The data frame must contain ones and zeros as well as missing values in case of structural missingness. One should be used to indicate if the primary study has been cited, otherwise zero. Of course, any missing value in the citation matrix affects the results. The package includes three main functions: the CCA function, the CCA underscore table function, and the CCA underscore heatmap function. The citation matrix, denoted as CM, is the first argument for each function. Additionally, all functions enable the incorporation of structural missingness in the matrix. The first function, CCA, calculates the overall CCA index for the entire citation matrix as a proportion and a percentage. Larger values indicate greater overlap of primary studies across the reviews. The second function, CCA underscore table, creates a data frame with the pairwise CCA calculations from the citation matrix. The third function, CCA underscore heatmap, uses the ggplot2R package, generating an upper triangle heatmap which shows the CCA calculations as a percentage for all possible pairs of reviews. The gray diagonal tiles in the graph present information about the number of single primary studies as well as the total number of primary studies included in each review. There are some advantages of the heatmap plot produced by the ccaR package. The plot is highly customizable as a ggplot object. It uses a sequential continuous color scale. It enables the incorporation of structural missingness in the citation matrix. It presents the single and total number of primary studies included in each review, and it is a publication-ready plot. Finally, a Shiny app is under development for those users who are unfamiliar with a command line environment. And here are some relative references. You can find more details about the package in our recently published paper with the title ccaR, a package for assessing primary study overlap across systematic reviews in overviews. Thank you very much for your attention.